April 1958, a young Texan named Van Cliburn is the surprise winner of the first International Tchaikovsky Piano Competition in Moscow. Coming just 6 months after the Soviets launched Sputnik, amid a mounting arms race and heightened Cold War tensions, the performance galvanized the nation and received worldwide attention.
New York City adds its own bravo to the worldwide crescendo of applause for Van Cliburn.
On his return to the U.S., the 23-year-old Cliburn was given a ticker tape parade down Broadway, the only classical musician ever so honored.
I was amazed, and I said, well, I think this may be not for me, but this may be, hopefully, the grandest moment, or a grand moment, for classical music.
50 years later, Van Cliburn lives in a grand home just outside Fort Worth, still very much the tall Texan, as he was so often described back then. He was recently feted by friends with a grand anniversary gala.
Classical music, classical art, is forever.
And he says he remembers every detail of his experience in Moscow.
I got off of the plane, and there was this very lovely, gracious, nice lady, Genrieta Belayeva, and I still know her to this day. And she said, Mr. Van Cliburn? And I thought, yes, welcome to Moscow. So all the time I was there, I never told them that in this country we pronounce it Van Cliburn. So I have two names, Van Cliburn and Van Cliburn.
When you went to Moscow, did you feel that you were part of history at that moment?
No, you didn't feel that way. The history was that this was the very first competition that they had had in Russia. And it was very exciting, particularly for me to see the jury. It was an unbelievable jury. Shostakovich, Emil Gilel, Sviatoslav Richter.
The greatest musicians of the Soviet Union.
Oborin. I mean, it was just unbelievable. And I mean, it was that was frightening. The jury was more frightening than the audience. But then after time passed and I got to have the privilege of being with them, they were so real and such nice people. And the simplicity within complexity of great music shone.
What does that mean?
Classical music is supposed to seem simple. Within simplicity is great, enormous complexity.
So you have to make it
you
seem
must make
simple.
It look simple or easy.
And how do you do
but
that?
I don't know. But but it is complex. There's so much to it. It's architecture. You have a time span that your mind must comprehend. When you walk out to play a piece, you must see the last note as you start the first note.
Back in 1958, Time magazine put Cliburn on its cover as the Texan who conquered Russia. But that's clearly not the way he saw it.
Well, that's not possible, not in great art. If they appreciate what you did, I am so grateful, because they were wonderful to me. They were such great audiences, I cannot begin to tell you. I didn't conquer anything. As a matter of fact, they conquered my heart.
Indeed, the Soviet audiences adored Cliburn, and soon enough, so did audiences around the world. His concerts were regularly sold out. His album of Tchaikovsky's first piano concerto, one of the pieces he played in Moscow, became the first classical recording to sell 1 million copies. From the beginning, as in this interview with Edward R. Murrow, Cliburn used a word that still peppers his speech today.
Of course, felt the deep personal gratification. But I'll tell you, Mr. Murrow, more than that, it's a terrific responsibility.
You feel that responsibility, yes. Mm-hmm. Because when you're dealing with great thoughts and great minds, such as the great composers, it inspires you so deeply, and you want to be faithful to what they wrote, you want to be able to convey that to someone else.
Did the responsibility become a kind of pressure to be more than just, I say just in quotations, just a great musician?
If you are a performer, mm-hmm. that is part of your raison d'etre, to perform mm-hmm. Many places, all over. But the pressure began when you first realized that your whole life was going to be in classical music. And I realized that when my mother first started teaching me when I was 3.
Cliburn's mother, Rilda B. O'Brien, attended the prestigious Juilliard School in New York before marrying Harvey Cliburn, a mid-level oil industry executive, and becoming a piano teacher. Van first served notice of his piano prowess by imitating his mother's students. And she was his only teacher until he went off to Juilliard himself at age 17. In one room of Cliburn's home, 2 of his 9 grand pianos sit side by side, much like how he and his mother would play when he was younger. The house is filled with mementos from his travels and portraits of the people he's gotten to know along the way, from Reagan to Rachmaninoff. Cliburn is a night owl who does his practicing alone after midnight.
This is the workbench.
This is it, huh?
This is it. As you practice over and you try to perfect something, when you go to a hall, you must then and there gauge the distance that you feel to be aware between yourself and the last person in the balcony.
Oh, you're aware of that last
person
and you want to reach them.
Yes, yeah. But when you get to the stage, I always practice with the lid down. There is no reason why to put the lid up. Because when you get to the hall, that is the moment of truth.
That's when it has to come
That's
out.
That's when it has to come out.
Are you a tough critic on yourself?
Very.
Really?
Too hard. Very, very hypercritical, yes. You want so for it to be not perfect, more than perfect.
In 1978, after the deaths of his father and his manager, Cliburn stopped playing in public. There had been no announcement, and for a while he was almost as famous for not playing as he'd been for his youthful victory. He says now it was all about having more time for other things he loves, especially opera. Cliburn was not heard again until 1987, when he performed at the White House for Ronald Reagan and Soviet President Mikhail Gorbachev. He made several very public returns after that, including a concert for 350,000 people in Chicago's Grant Park in 1994. And he still performs, though he's reduced the number of concerts to about 6 a year. Cliburn is also well known now for another competition, the one that bears his name. The Van Cliburn International Music Competition, held every 4 years, was started in 1962 in his honor by music teachers and private citizens in Fort Worth. Recently, a group of past winners and their families returned to Texas as part of the 50th anniversary celebration for Cliburn. Olga Kern performed with her young son.
Young people who are so talented that come here. When I go to hear them, I am so inspired. I want to go home and practice. Rachmaninoff said once, great music is enough for a lifetime, but a lifetime is not enough for great music.
And you still have the same curiosity
yes,
and excitement?
And the same joy in hearing these compositions. But it's always there. It will be there after you and I and everyone we know today are dead. That music will still be alive.